So as the year is coming to an end, we are finally having a look at the second version of the Airfrost A318 in the current livery from Harper Wings. The aircraft model is much anticipated and we have been waiting for it quite a while, but has it been worth the wait? That hello and welcome to a new episode of Review, where we today will take a closer look at an Airbus A318 of Air France. At the front of the box, we have the cutout so we can get a glimpse of the aircraft model inside, and at the top of the box, we have the Air France branding. Then the backside of the box unfortunately continues the trend of 2020. It looks absolutely terrible with this additional cutout. It's not protective of the aircraft model, and it just looks really cheap. Please, Harper, reconsider this for 2021. And quickly, before we get too far into today's review, it is worth mentioning that this aircraft model does come with a stand. And here she is, the Airbus A318-100 in the current livery of Air France. Now, this is actually the second version of this aircraft model. The first one was released quite a few years back with a different registration code, but other than that, they should be pretty much identical. Although I haven't reviewed the first version for some reason, so that might be a job for 2021. But let's focus on this aircraft model that we have right in front of us, and we start off with the tail section, where we, on the vertical stabilizer, have the Air France branding integrated in the thick blue line. We then have the flag of the European Union. On the fuselage, we then find the full registration code of the aircraft, and we do of course also have a little bit of detailing around the APU exhaust. At the front of the aircraft and across the fuselage, we then have the Air France branding once again. Underneath that, we have the aircraft type specification. Then we, of course, also have a SkyTeam logo, of which Air France is a founding member. And underneath the cockpit windows, we then have the Air France KLM Group logo. Then, of course, the cockpit section itself consists only of the cockpit windows and the window wipers. A little bit underwhelming, in my opinion. And also, I think the cockpit windows of this A318 look a little bit too big, in my opinion. Also, the nose shape is not ideal. I think it is a little bit too pointy. Still, I think it looks much better than what we get with all other A320 family aircraft from Harper Wings these days. Then we can move on to the engine nacelles, which have been kept in all white, as is usual with all Air France aircraft. Which is also usual for them is the fact that they do carry the historic Air France logo, which Harper has printed on next to the silver leading edge. And that's it for printed details on these nacelles. And also the physical detailing of these engines, I mean, it's not bad, but we've seen it better, and it kind of is staggering that, I mean, honestly speaking, the engines look like they're old parts that Harper just needed to get rid of. Because, I mean, let's just take a quick look at the engines of the S7 A320 that was released also in 2020. So how come that there is such a big difference in the physical detailing? Harper, maybe you can explain that. But let's move on to the wings, because we should definitely also take a look at those to get an impression of this aircraft model. And we start off with the top side, where we have the different flap slats and spoilers carved out very nicely. We have the markings for the emergency exit, which we also have on the fuselage, which I definitely didn't forget to film. And of course, we have some different shades of gray for additional detailing. Also, the underside of the wings, I think, looks decent. Here we also have the full registration code of the aircraft once again. And then we have the wingtip fences. But also here, I mean, they look decent. But in other releases in 2020, I would say Harper has done a better job, which again leads me back to the thought, maybe this is not such a new model. Where it probably isn't bad that this most likely isn't a new Harper Wings model is the fact when we look at the landing gear, because this landing gear is the standard landing gear that Harper used around 2008 for all the A320 family aircraft models. And this landing gear is the most realistic landing gear Harper has ever used for these aircraft types. And it looks so much better than anything that Harper is offering us today. And even though, yes, it's not without any issues, especially the front landing gear is very fragile, but still, it's so much better than anything else from Harper Wings these days. I would wish they would start using this across all the A320 family aircrafts again. And then last but not least, we also have the doors to the cargo compartments printed on here in the backside of the aircraft and here at the front of the aircraft. So there we have it, the Airbus A318-100 in the current livery of Air France of Harper Wings in scale 1 to 500. And what can we say about this aircraft model? Well, frankly, to call this a 2020 release from Harper Wings is an insult to the, well, intellect and to the eyesight of any collector. Because this aircraft model is very clearly not the standard that Harper is putting out in the year 2020. It is the standard that Harper would have put out around 2008. In some areas that's good, and in some areas it's bad, but let's go through it point by point. When we look at the print quality, there isn't actually much negative to say. The only thing I'm not happy about is the fact that the cockpit windows do seem to be quite large for this aircraft. And of course, I would like to have a few more printed details here and there, but overall, it's actually pretty decent. The physical detailing of this aircraft model is, however, much more of a mixed bag. I do actually prefer the mold that this aircraft model has, even though the nose is a little bit too pointy in my opinion, but it's still looking much better in my opinion than anything else we have gotten from Harper Wings in 2020. Other places where we can see that this is definitely not a new release from Harper Wings is when we look at how the wings were mounted. That's definitely not how Harper does it these days. Also, the physical detailing of the engines doesn't match the usual standard from Harper Wings these days. What is, however, lovely is the fact that they have used the old landing gear because it just looks so much better than any of the current landing gears from Harper Wings. Ultimately, I would say it's not a bad model, and I've bought it and I'm happy to have it in my collection. But there's one thing that I just have to point out. Harper hasn't released any A318s in what, 3 or 4 years? And in all that time, they had the opportunity to rework the A318 mold with all the details that come with it. And they haven't done a single thing. That's not just lazy, it's simply pathetic. So with that conclusion, it is probably the best aircraft model for Harper Wings to end 2021, because it really sums up everything that is wrong with this company. And on that note, it is also time to end today's video, which of course is the last one in 2020. If you have enjoyed this video, then don't forget to leave a like, that would be very much appreciated. And of course, if you are new around here, why not hit subscribe? That would be absolutely awesome. With that, I'd like to wish you a happy new year. Hope to see you soon again. I'm checking out, and bye.